this world. What do you want from me? You have everything. My child.
We come to England.
Who's not being serious now? You guys would just do exactly the same thing, only slower. I'm only a human being. I'm only a person, a woman, as long as I'm disbelieved. As soon as somebody believes my story, I'm dead.
At last, the coach crossed the causeway to the Queen of Cities. Everything that happens
this morning. I love you very much.
On whom but on my husband should I fawn?
On Mortimer?
Thou wrongest me.
Thou art too familiar with that Mortimer. By thy means is governed and exiled. But I would wish thee reconcile the lords.
You're hurt, ma'am?
I'm dead, sir.
Dead. That's serious. Can I help?
Will you marry me?
Ma'am, I would gladly. But I fear my ankle is twisted.
The air. Everything will be different in the future. We're mutating.
You know, your obsession with perfection is quite ludicrous.
I want to be perfect, don't you?
Christ, no.
Then I don't see how we can be friends.
Neither do I.
Manish Muff, diving size queen.
And all the while we think we understand these strange new shapes because we are the masters of technology, because we brought it into being. But then one day we find that we are hopelessly ensnared. That society has vanished and something formless has emerged.
What's that lipstick you have on?
Le Manet Rouge. It's our new fall color. Just came in this morning.
Le Manet. What's Manet?
Pussycat. The red pussycat.
Meow!
That must be Babu Janeda.
I've been studying your drawings. Your analytic engine weaves algebraic patterns like Jacquard wove flowers. It's so beautiful.
I wish others shared your enthusiasm. I finished the first notes that you wrote. They're exquisite. I had no idea.
And everyone else's. I never see you getting out your beanbag, Lottie.
I don't think you know me at all, Muriel.
No, I don't give a fuck, dear.
Swat.
You're an arty little shit, Deacon. You're a waste of space and you bore me. Why didn't you go and pump somewhere else? Miss Hitler was more generous than you. Anyway, do go on, Isabel. Yes, sir, anyway.
I'll take the kids and get them some tea.
Yeah, good.
Let Mummy get some rest now.
I grew up there, too.
What part of Novare?
East Lake. Right out near the filling station.
You went to school there?
Sure.
What did you say your name was?
George Barber.
It's funny, I don't remember you.
Well, I looked, very different back then.
You must have.
The dream of peace, the dream of achievement. The dream of hearing someone say these words. When they really, truly mean them. I love you, David. To keep.
Just say?
She said the tea was delicious today.
Why does she insist on encrypting language? Neither of you do that.
She says she needs something of her own.
Well, I can understand that. It's perfectly reasonable.
Trust me, it's no fun.
So, tell me your thoughts on this crazy little project of ours.
First, I think it's a great book.
La Roche is a fun character, isn't it?
Absolutely. And Orlean makes orchids so fascinating. Plus her musings on flora.
I will be responsible for the overall direction of the investigation. And
I'm supposed to do as I'm told. Isn't that correct, Judge?
That's correct, Colonel. Why don't we have lunch?
What the police think?
Thousand doesn't know. It's probably not murder. There wasn't a mark on the body.
You had a good look then. Kind of keep your eyes off a woman, even if she's dead.
Thought I'd drop by. Just checking in.
Well, I don't remember any happy ending between us, Don. No reconciliation, nothing.
You left me, Penny, remember?
Yeah. Very clearly.
A year and a half of huge effort and heavy losses. Large parts of France, and most of Belgium, remained under German occupation. both sides had dug in, and a line of trenches stretched from the channel to Switzerland.
Beautiful, Audrey. Seriously. He's a cheese ball.
I don't think so. Besides, that's just the role he plays. Maybe we could work on this together later.
You're insane.
The road to salvation begins tonight. Right now.
Do you understand?
I have nothing to hide.
Stephanie? Good news is that I have your test results here, so I won't be asking you to do those again. We'll just be talking. And anytime you'd like to speak with your parents or talk privately with your lawyer, that's fine. Okay?
On la rapportera demain.
Ah. Do you think it's doable?
Yeah, we have some good ideas. You say move, we move. The ideas don't look so good, we back off, reassess.
Okay.
Is that okay? You understand her? Okay, proceed.
Just before daybreak.
I think I may have given you the wrong impression.
Beg pardon?
Well, married women don't customarily sit around in the middle of the night with strange men in hotels.
I wouldn't know what a married woman does or doesn't do.
You think that might be enough carrots?
What?
For the salad?
You know, you really are a negative person.
What?
I've tried to ignore it, to remain upbeat.
You know you can't do this alone.
Smoke, do you?
No.
Your mommy's smoking in the street outside.
Honey.
Not a good look.
You just sit here and smoke.
You're a kind man.
Mm-hmm.
You're a kind man.
Agua.
Para la bella señorita.
Gracias. Suspicion.
You are a great disappointment to me. You call yourself my son and act like a king.
Edmund, come with me.
Be my king. I'll let you rule.
Good afternoon, ma'am. I hope this isn't an inconvenient time.
Well, it is, actually.
Well, we just had a couple of quick questions for you.
What's this about?
Do you know where you're spending the afterlife?
Oh, yes, I do, as a matter of fact. I'm going straight to hell. Eternal damnation, a whole bit. Thank you for
in a 27-year career. What do you have to say for yourselves?
You can't do this. They'll eat him alive in there.
Where?
What's the name of the place again?
Juvenile refuge.
Juvenile refuge. Sounds like jail.
Just find the boy and deliver him to social services. Nothing else is in your power.
I take three with me, then.
That would be great, and I'll take
we'll
the rest over here.
We'll go this way, kids, okay?
Come along, guys.
Hello.
Hi, everybody.
How is she to know what she'll find inside there? She's an emotionally damaged girl, and you're emotionally bereft.
This interruption is unacceptable. We insist you run a scan on your program.
Sorry about that. Glitch fixed.
Oh, negative. That's delicious.
Blood on a stick.
On a stick.
That's not bad.
Very refreshing, especially when you're in a hot spot. Checkmate.
Passengers, this is not you. This is disorder. This is size 10 chaos. This, see this? This is death. In this locomotive we call home, there is one thing.
Come with me.
To fucking Lutz.
Please.
Give me your hand. You've nothing to fear. You're always anxious before you travel. I admit you appear to be suffering a more acute attack on this occasion, but truly and honestly, oh dear God, what have you done to your fingernails?
I beg your pardon?
This diabolical varnish, the colour is completely wrong.
Oh really, don't you like it?
It's not...
Welcome, Donald. Welcome to Snuff, where we are teaching the strong-willed man how to dress, think, eat, fuck. Do you like the magazine, Donald?
Oh, yeah, it's pretty much all I read.
Good answer. Look, this is ours. This is ours. Right, we made this. What's our demographic?
Every fucking one. Yeah.
Thank you. You can go now.
I don't think so. Anyway, I suppose you'll have your mummy phase and I'll have my daddy phase. But one way or another, we're just going to grow old together, aren't we?
Terry Speckwith in an indifferent universe.
You think too little of yourself.
Oh, you think you see through me, do you? Well, you don't. But I see through you!
Yes, he did have to take a break. Minor injury, high ankle sprain.
What did you think I meant?
No, nothing. I saw your sister earlier. She was trying to resurrect some old gossip about Bear.
Oh, I'm sure she was, that cow. She wouldn't know a news story if it bit her on the posterior.
Yeah, well, she...
High ankle sprain? Is that really the best you could come up with? We all know about the womanizing and the drinking jags and the trips to San Badu.
Only mentioned Al-Qaeda once. Your own vice president has advocated a much smaller and simpler counter-terrorism approach to incapacitate what is estimated to be little more than 100 Al-Qaeda fighters that still remain in Afghanistan, to refocus on what it was that started this war in the first place.
Brando's new era, with me, and with new core values, environment and life. Awesome!
Oh, you're much more fun than the last chief executive.
Well, former CEO Nancy's my sister, but... We're very different people, we have very different ways of being, we have very different business ethics.
She didn't trust you because you're hypocrites.
Can we take Olga to her room, please, Tanner?
No, Miss Tanner! Call Olga Cup! She's had enough. And is going to pack your things and get the fuck out from this box of rabies!
Turpentine brandy. It cools the head and warms the dog bones.
It may snow tonight.
Really? Thank you very much. Wow.
To whom it may concern.
She sees the future.
Ah, no.
Complicated, but we've got to protect society, haven't we?
Just but they're just as much part of society as anybody else. That's what they would say. And
Well, I haven't set any bombs recently, have you?
No, but you haven't necessarily felt the need to, because you felt that you have a political voice.
Mm-hmm. When I read...
I'm your nephew. I'm David Copperfield from the Rookery.
Mr. Dick!
I've been ill-used and put to work not fit for me, and you're the only family I have.
Come inside, yes. Come inside. Janet!
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Dick! Janet!
What did he say?
Strange. He gave it away. He gave it to Thanos.
Willingly?
Yes.
Why?
I have no idea. Maybe he made a mistake.
Who killed the Baron?
We thought that's what we thought. We were all discussing that.
You have committed premeditated vampicide.
Pass the judgment, Tilda.
I pronounce these three guilty. Raise your fangs, all who agree.
If you could enter this world of the last men, you would find some things familiar and much that would seem strangely distorted and perverse. You would encounter creatures recognizably human, yet in your view, grotesque.
Hello, can I come in?
Hello. Here we are.
Well, there's a nice little scene. Dogs waiting for lunch. Oh, we had any rest. Well, dear.
And once furious wings. The air gasps at its fading shadow.
Remains, in my opinion, the most eloquent and certainly loudest artistic voice of his rowdy generation. How does this pivotal piece come to find its way into its unique position as a permanent installation here at the Clampett Collection? The story begins in a mess hall.
Bring her back.
I'm sorry, but I can't. No one can. Her death is an absolute point in time.
Absolute.
Unchangeable. Unmovable. Without her death, you would never have defeated Dormammu and become the Sorcerer Supreme and the guardian of the Eye of Agamotto.
Three witches, perfectly simple and theoretically safe.
I was imprisoned by Solomon precisely because I cried out my heart's desire. Only by granting you yours may I earn my release.
Yes, well, I appreciate the symmetry, but the thing is this, I cannot for the life of me summon up one eligible wish, and you're asking me for three.
Is there any life in you? Are you even alive?
You know, in some cult...
I don't know if it was a window, but it felt repetitive and... Yeah, all night.
That's strange, because nobody else has mentioned anything at all about any noise whatsoever.
Really?
Yeah.
That does surprise me. It was pervasive. I would be very grateful if you could make sure that that doesn't happen again tonight and check.
My sister's folly. The sentimental fool. She gave you life, Pinocchio, when you were not supposed to have it. No more than a chair or a table should. As a result, you cannot truly, truly die.